2020, which was posted a day before, we were discussing on science and technology as a very crucial or an important area from the UPSC prelims 2020 point of view. And today, I'll be continuing my discussion and I may be also incorporating areas that are important from the mains point of view with regard to science and technology. In our previous session, we stopped our discussion or we ceased our discussion exactly after dealing with space technology, and I would be beginning my area from space technology. In the previous session, we dealt with how to deal with the space technology area, from where you can expect 5 to 7% of questions or maximum 5% of questions, especially with regard to the major missions that have been conducted by NASA, by the European Space Agency, by the Indian Space Research Organization, by JAXA and many other similar space research organizations of different nations, especially those nations who are seriously engaged with regard to the concept of space research. Today, after space technology, another major area of interest with regard to UPSC prelims 2020 would be the nuclear technology. We know very well that nuclear power had been a matter of greater concern for all nations around the world. And many people, especially many candidates, study nuclear technology from purely a fission fusion point of view, right from NCERT. Please avoid this limitation, or please avoid this nature or this methodology of study, since it is absolutely of no help to any candidate who prepare for UPSC prelims 2020, especially who want to score maximum marks in science and technology domain. You cannot ever expect any questions related to basic nuclear science. Whatever questions UPSC asked or is currently asking or is going to ask potentially would be related to the current news item related to nuclear technology and not about how things work. I repeat, how things work is not important from the current UPSC point of view. This is not only applicable to nuclear technology, but this is applicable to space technology, this is applicable to agricultural research, this is applicable to biotechnology, etc. That basic science is not much required, but you need to have, an especially now almost 65 or 66% of candidates, or even 75% of candidates are coming from the science domain, you have a basic idea of science, so that how things work is not important. Then what is important is the policies, programs, and institutions associated with nuclear power. I repeat, policies, programs, and institutions associated with nuclear power in India. We know very well that we have the BARC, the Baba Atomic Research Center in India, and many other prominent institutions associated with nuclear power. How the nuclear command system works in India. We know very well that the PMO or the Prime Minister and the Prime Minister's office is given a direct charge with regard to the use of nuclear power, especially for war purpose. Our policy of no first use, we know very well that we follow the policy of no first use. We will never use a nuclear weapon against any country unless and until they use the same. And how the PMO, the Prime Minister's office, is involved in this matter. What is the strategic military command of India that deals with nuclear power precisely? And finally, what all are the recent developments in this domain? Other than that policy related nuclear technology, we cannot ever expect a question related to how things work. So you can definitely leave that area, or you can definitely skip that area, since it is not important from the exam point of view. But you need to have a clear idea with regard to recent missions, recent developments, policy related matter, and defense policy, and the major nuclear related doctrines. Here comes the Gujral doctrine of a former Prime Minister, respected I.K. Gujral. The Gujral doctrine, how it is connected with the nuclear technology, especially the no first use policy. Then again, the nuclear command and control system of India and how it is different from Pakistan. In Pakistan, of course, it is directly controlled by the army. On the other hand, in India, it is not like that. In India, we have a separate strategic command for nuclear power and the use of nuclear power. And finally, nuclear power for energy. We know very well that almost currently that percentage is increasing. Even today, 12 to 15% of a total power comes from nuclear power, and the number is increasing slowly. Kerala does not have a nuclear power plant, but Tamil Nadu does have one. So the importance of nuclear power in our power pool is increasing like anything. So nuclear energy as a source of electricity, that becomes a very important area. And what is the total power share of nuclear energy with regard to electricity generation in India? Because the country runs on electricity, and definitely what is the share of nuclear energy with regard to power generation? That becomes very important. Okay, so that is nuclear technology again. And once nuclear technology is over, once this part is over, our five major areas with regard to UPSC prelims 2020 is over. Then what is left? Again, how can you plug every loophole with regard to your preparation to science and technology? Or what are additional areas a candidate should read when he prepares for science and technology becomes very important. These additional areas are perhaps very limited, but that limited number of areas has to be properly read, articulated and recorded by a candidate for future use. I repeat, properly read, articulated and recorded by a candidate for future use. How is that possible? Again, I spoke to you about the Hindu and the Hindu page on science. And again, the articles that come in Hindu, other than the Hindu page on science, a number of articles related to the science and technology domain that is published in the Hindu newspaper. How can a candidate identify something is important and something is not? First of all, I have a precise recommendation to you. Whoever is giving importance to science and technology, please cut relevant science and technology items whenever you see it in the Hindu, and please record it, or please keep it as a record for future reference. Imagine in 2015 paper, there was a question related to Project Loom. Project Loom is connected with space technology, and where technology and digital technology is also involved. And the question was directly handpicked from the Hindu, and many candidates who saw that question were a bit confused, since they haven't heard about Project Loom. But Project Loom was clearly given in the Hindu newspaper, and any candidate who read the Hindu newspaper thoroughly and recorded it for future reference can have a clear idea with regard to Project Loom. Other than Hindu newspaper, again, many candidates use a number of current affair magazines instituted by different institutes or provided by different institutes. Nothing wrong in using them, but please don't read science and technology too much extensively for prelims, but you can have a general understanding. That general understanding is enough, but that general understanding should include a deep down understanding where whenever a question is posed, the candidate should be in a position to eliminate wrong answers and to arrive at the right answer. Finally, I already mentioned about biotech plus the third area, that is disease or illness related area. Of course, medical research is also very important for a candidate. What all are the recent developments in the domain of medical research in India, both in the domain or that area that deals with human beings as well as with animals? So recent developments in the medical domain and the terms used or the concepts or the terminology set that is used with medical research also becomes important. So the candidate should develop a primary idea related to all these areas. In the previous session, we began it exactly from biotech, and now we are ending it with medical research. So if a candidate is developing a broad-based understanding, I'm repeating again, you're not supposed to learn anything thoroughly, but if you develop a broad-based understanding related to these areas, your task is accomplished. And I assure you that 100%, certainly 100% marks can be scored with regard to those 15 questions, or maybe I expect 17 to 20 questions this year, including science current affair questions. We'll be having a separate area on how to deal with current affairs. There we'll discuss how to deal with science current affairs also precisely. Again, in this year, you can expect 17 to 20 questions for UPSC prelims. And once a candidate is clear with regard to all these areas and he properly brushes up all these areas, it is assured that you can score 100% marks. It is my personal assurance. It is Naipunya's assurance, definitely. 100% marks with regard to UPSC prelims 2020 science area. Finally, when we deal with again mains, of course, prelims preparation has to happen hand in hand or hand in glove with that of mains preparation. That is a reality, definitely. We know very well that paper, if we take GS papers, GS4 is ethics paper, GS3 has some science and technology areas, and GS1 also does have some science and technology area. If we go for a close understanding of the syllabus, we can understand that there the candidate or the understanding of the candidate with regard to 2-3 things are very important. We'll be discussing about main science and technology later. Anyway, once you are preparing for prelims, especially you're getting more time to prepare for prelims, you should also read a question from the mains point of view. The science and tech policy of the government is a potential area in the main syllabus. Indigenization is another potential area. We know very well that what is indigenization. Again, then the third thing, of course, is the contributions of Indians precisely with regard to the developments in science and technology. I repeat, recent developments, especially developments related to research in India related to science and technology, that's the first thing. Of course, in the world too, but Indian focus. The paper is prepared from a focus with regard to India. And once that is over, the second important area is the indigenization. How we went for a generic option. How we developed Indian options for those things available in the world market. And how successfully we could introduce and we could engage or we could use those options. And finally, the contributions of Indians in different walks or domains of science and technology. Again, mere physics or mere chemistry is not important. You need to go for a larger ambit. You need to go for a combination of all these, like contributions of Indians in the domain of biotech. Whatever I said for you for prelims, biotech definitely, in the domain of space tech, in the domain of nuclear tech, of course in the domain of defense tech, if it has a science component or if it has a science aspect involved in it, then again in the domain of medical research, in the domain of agricultural research, etc., 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 where all Indian scientists have contributed their own might. We know very well that we have a galaxy of great scientists, like the old Chandrasekhar, the great scientists who contributed a lot. People like C.V. Raman, then our Dr. A.P.J. Abdul Kalam, and many others. And we do have a galaxy of scientists, especially in the domain of space technology, in the domain of missile technology, in the domain of nuclear technology, who contributes immensely. And that is the Indian contribution precisely. And from a mains angle, a candidate should also know what all are the contributions of Indians with regard to the domain of science and technology. We'll continue this discussion in another session. Thank you.